Hey Ross, where my money makes money. I'm sorry that I skipped Black Friday and I didn't release a video, but take heed to Black Friday and Cyber Monday. This is the time where organizations throughout the US and sometimes even in other countries, they do what they call the Black Friday and Cyber Monday. It's that day right after Thanksgiving where you are full, fat, and happy, and all of your serotonin is just pumping, and they get you to spend all your hard work and money. Now granted, if some of you are taking this opportunity to go out and buy all your Christmas presents, then it may be a saving grace for you. Or maybe you're waiting for Cyber Monday, where that's times two saving grace. And what I mean is that you'll be saving more money than you would if you bought it in an off season, if you bought it during regular holiday season and not during these two particular days. Now granted, some of these are gimmicks, okay? And I won't say scams because these companies are not really scamming you, but what they're doing, they're giving you this big profit margin of 40% off, whether it be online or in the store. Now, I have never been the one, never. And I won't say that I never will, but I feel it's a 99.9% chance that I never, ever will stand in line for hours on end for 40 or 50% off a product. It's just not who I am. It's not that I'm some tootie good shoes. The point is, I don't want to bear the weather. I don't want to wait for something. How about I just work hard and save up the money, and some of you like, well, you're going to pay that full price. And you have a point. But my point is, it's just not in me to do that. Now, the other day I saw people at Target and they were standing in line a day prior, and I think Target might have opened up at midnight, but they start getting in line around like 3 or 4 o'clock, okay? At that time, I want to say it was like 20 people in line. And I got it. You want the best possible deals. And here's the thing. If you're going to use these 2 days for your birthday shopping, for your Christmas shopping, then the one thing that you need to do is look at the papers that they give you. They actually tell you, whether it be online or in the paper, of all the percentages that they have on certain products. Now, some of you have been eyeing this 65, 70-inch LED, 120 hertz, smart TV from whoever, and you're not even doing your research, because when you went in there and you rushed, you the third in line, you spent overnight, you was in the tent, people bought you hot chocolate and cocoa and oodles and noodles for you to eat so you can wait there all overnight, and maybe you had a bucket to defecate in, but when you got there, the TV wasn't even on sale. This is the point I'm trying to make. The only thing I'm trying to make out of this video is right here, Ross World, is pinpoint what you want to buy. Pinpoint how much you want to spend. Go in there with cash. Go in there with cash. Now, with Cyber Monday, yes, you have to use your credit card, but have a set limit in your head. And last but not least, not everyone is deserving of a $100 gift. Not everyone is deserving of a $25 gift. Some people that you always get gifts for, just because you feel as though they're going to give you a gift, or you may feel as though that they deserve a gift, but you have an immediate family that you really want to get them something, but you may be stressed out. You may miss your light bill. You may miss your water bill. First and foremost, do not miss any bills for anybody's present. Not anybody's present, not your kids' presents, not your mom, your father, your sister, your brother, not your husband, your wife, your girlfriend, your boyfriend. Do not miss any payments to buy somebody a darn gift. First and foremost is your own security and comfort, okay? Your own security and comfort. That means having all the amenities of home, running water, light, heat, electric, etc., your mortgage or your rent paid, whatever it may be. Pay all your bills first before you go out and buy somebody some gifts. I know that this time is very tempting because you have Black Friday and you have Cyber Monday, like, oh, I can save so much money, but at the same time, you can spend a lot as well. So during this time, it's okay to buy somebody a gift. Not a gift card, but a gift. And I just want to leave you with a little nugget of information so that you may say, well, you know, last year, this person gave me a card, but I gave them a $50 gift card. And I'm not saying go tit for tat. I'm just saying strategically, look at who you usually get gifts, and is it really worth it? Or can you just go to the dollar store and get 25 cards to give to people and say, Merry Christmas, happy holidays, etc. This is Ross Ware. Hopefully I changed just a little bit of your mind. Hopefully I tweaked, altered, just so you to think outside of your normal buying present style. If you like this video, give it a thumbs up, ring the notification bell, so every time I release a video, you see it first. I'm out.